Hey all, as mentioned in my previous video about the problem statement, I'll tell you how to write a problem statement on a step-to-step chronological manner. So I told that my research topic is going to be consumer purchase behavior in COVID-19. So this is a broad title of my research. So it is consumer purchase behavior in COVID-19. So this is going to be my research title. So before constructing the problem statement, split the research title into different parts. So here, consumer is one important terminology. Purchase is the second important terminology. Behavior is the third important terminology. COVID-19 is the fourth important terminology. So we have to construct or frame a problem which is common for the consumers, which is associated with a purchase action, which is also associated with the purchase behavior or the personal behavioral traits of the consumer, and the situation here or the environment here or the scenario here is going to be the COVID-19 situation, right? So this is the very first step. So the first step is nothing but take a title, your research title, your own research title, break it into different types of components and see what are all the different types of themes associated in your study. So are you clear with the very first step? Shall I proceed with the second step? Okay, second step. Purchase behavior. Purchase behavior is a very common thing which everyone have explored. But with regard to COVID-19, what are all the problems associated? So that is what we are going to explore here. So can I put it in this way? There is a fear in purchase. Fear is a problem, right? All the stores in the city is closed. So where do I go and purchase? How do I purchase? What is the source for me to get the products and services? So fear is a major problem associated with the purchase behavior. Next one. High pricing strategies. I have not withdrawn any money. I don't have money now. But at this time, during the COVID time, the marketers have increased the price. So if the prices are going to be high, so what would I do? How would I spend? So spending pattern and price is a major problem. So I'm putting price and spending pattern. Third one, I'm not bothered about my friends or my relatives or other people who are near to my house. But I would ensure that I will get all the products and I would stock it for myself. So can we put it in this way? There is a greedy intention to purchase. So that is also a problem. So next one. If the government is going to impose 144 lockdown, how would I go for a purchase? I can't step outside. So what would happen to my daily consumption pattern? My sophisticated and comfortable purchase pattern, what would happen to it? So I would study about the impact of the government policies, rules and regulation on my purchase behavior. So that is also an issue. Next one. I am a very loyal customer. I've been purchasing products from one particular store for the past 5 to 10 years, and the marketer and the store owner knows me very well, and he has always been genuine to me by selling the product at the right price. But now, due to this COVID-19, a product which was priced for 100 is now priced for 150 rupees. So why is the marketer doing this? I'm a loyal customer. What happened to my loyalty? So there is a question mark on your loyalty. There is a question mark on the goodwill which you had on the marketer. So when you split consumer behavior, you can see what are all the problems. See problem 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 problems are there here. So this is a method of splitting the main concept in your research title and then seeing what would be the different types of possible problem which are associated, not problem, but possible problem. So that is the second stage. So am I clear with the second stage and can I proceed with the third stage? Okay, in the third stage, I told you that what is the relationship associated with the problem, right? So in my last video, I spoke about the relationship. If you see all these factors, there is a relationship. Simple example, I'll tell you. The price increases. Suddenly during the COVID-19 situation, the price of hand sanitizers has increased very drastically. And the store in which I was buying a product for the past 5 years has also done it. So can I relate that if the price increases, there's a hit on the loyalty. If the price increases, there's a hit or an influence on the loyalty factors. This is the first relationship. Second relationship you see, we can take, okay, the government has imposed 144 and the marketers are also running out of the stock. So ultimately for them to survive, they have to increase the prices. So government rules and regulations has an increase on marketing, right? So government rules and regulation has a relationship on marketers to increase the prices. The government, see the third relationship, government policy has been implemented, that is 144. So that has an impact on the pricing strategies given by the marketers. The prices have been increased and ultimately that affects the loyalty of the consumer. So this is a direct relationship and this is an indirect relationship. So direct problem, indirect problem. So this is the third step. So are you clear with the third step? Can I proceed with the next one? So now you are clear with the problem factors and what are all the different types of relationship. Now you have to write it, narrate it properly. So I'll tell you how to narrate it. In this research, importance has been given to consumer behavior as a major theme. And a lot of problems have already been explored by the past researchers. But one unique problem which I'm going to explore in my research is going to be on the greedy purchase behavior and fear involved in the purchase action of the consumers. So you can take these two variables and then you can explore this in depth. So then to further divide, what would be the different types of problem factors associated with greed and fear? So this is how you have to scrutinize your problem statement. It is a funnel approach. You had vast information, vast ideas, then you crushed it, then you made it very simple, you made it very focused. Now this is the focused area. So using this, you have to develop your problem statement. So please follow all these methods and try to come up with a very good problem statement writing. If you have any doubts, you can send me a mail or you can comment. I would respond very immediately. Thank you.